very good day, viewers. I welcome you to the practical session on general characteristics of chordates. Starting with introduction, the name of the phylum chordate is derived from two Greek words, the chord meaning a string or cord and ata meaning bearing. The common characteristics of this phylum are the presence of a notochord, a hollow dorsal nerve cord, pharyngeal slits, an endostyle and a post anal tail for at least some period of their life cycles. It is the highest and most important phylum comprising a vast variety of living and extinct animals. This phylum includes a vast group of diverse animals ranging from ascidian to man. Three fundamental chordate characters. All the chordates possess three common fundamental characteristics at some stages in their life history. These three common fundamental morphological features are, number one, notochord, that is a longitudinal supporting rod-like structure. Number two, dorsal tubular hollow nerve cord. And number three, pharyngeal gill slits. We now discuss each of these. Number one, notochord or chorda dorsalis. The notochord from two Greek words, noton meaning back and chorda meaning cord, is a rod-like, elongated, elastic structure situated just above the alimentary canal and immediately beneath the dorsal tubular nerve cord. It is composed of large vacuolated notochordal cells enclosed in an outer fibrous and an inner elastic sheath of connective tissue. It serves as a primitive internal skeleton and acts as a rigid axis but permits movements of the body. It may persist throughout life as in lancelet, lamprey and some fishes, or it may be replaced partially or completely by a backbone or vertebral column. Number two, dorsal tubular nerve cord. In chordates, there is a dorsal hollow or tubular fluid-filled nerve cord just above the anterior posterior axis of the body. The nerve cord is formed by an infolding of mid-dorsal strip of neural ectoderm and encloses a cavity or canal, the neurocele. The nerve cord lies above the notochord and outside the coelom, extending lengthwise in the body. This tubular nerve cord persists throughout the life in chordates. In vertebrates, the anterior region of nerve cord becomes specialized to form a cerebral vesicle or brain, which is enclosed in a protective cartilaginous or bony cranium. The posterior part of nerve cord transforms into spinal cord, which is protected within the neural canal of the vertebral column. Number 3. Pharyngeal gill slits. The gill slits have many alternative names such as gill clefts, pharyngeal or brachial clefts, visceral or brachial pouches. In all the chordates, at some stages of their life history, a series of paired internal gill slits or gill clefts perforate through the pharyngeal wall of the gut behind the mouth. Gill slits are paired openings leading from the pharynx to the exterior. Lateral outpushing of the ectodermal lining of pharynx meet and fuse with ectodermal inpushings from the exterior, the intervening walls being broken down. Thus, the gill clefts are formed. These three common characters appear during early embryonic life of all the chordates, but rarely persist in the adult as in branchiostoma. Let's learn other general features of phylum chordata. These are aquatic, aerial or terrestrial. All are free living with no fully parasitic forms. Body is small to large, bilaterally symmetrical and metamerically segmented. A post-anal tail usually projects beyond the anus at some stage of life and may or may not persist in the adult. Exoskeleton is present and is well developed in most vertebrates. Body wall is triploblastic, marked by the presence of three germ layers, ectoderm, mesoderm and endoderm. A well-developed true cilium is always present, which is enterocelic or schizocelic in origin. A cartilaginous or bony, living and jointed endoskeleton is present in the majority of vertebrate members. A complete digestive system is present in this phylum. Blood vascular system is closed. A well-developed hepatic portal system is present. Excretory system is well-developed in chordates. Sexes are separate with rare exceptions. Moving ahead, we detail the characteristics of chordata with various examples according to classification. Phylum chordata is divided into two groups, that is acrania or protocordata and craniata or eucordata. Both these groups show contrasting characters. Group A, acrania or protocordata. In Greek, a meaning absent and cranion meaning head. And in Greek, protos means first and chord means chord. The members of this group are all marine, small, primitive or lower chordates. The cranium, jaws, vertebral column and paired appendages are absent in this group. About 2000 species are found in acrania group. This group is further divided into three subphyla: hemichordata, urochordata and cephalochordata. Subphylum 1, hemichordata. In Greek, hemi means half and chord means chord. These are solitary and colonial, mostly tubiculous and exclusively marine animals. Body is soft, fragile, vermiform and divisible into proboscis, collar and trunk. Cilium is enterocoelous. Buccal diverticulum, earlier considered as notochord, is present in the proboscis. Gill slits, when present, are paired and one too numerous. Circulatory system is simple, closed type and well developed. Excretion occurs by a single glomerulus situated in the proboscis. Reproduction is mostly sexual. Fertilization is external. This subphylum is grouped into four classes. Class 1, Enteropneusta. In Greek, enteron means gut and neustis means head. These are commonly known as ekron or tongue worms. Enteropneusts are solitary and burrowing worm-like animals. Alimentary canal is straight. Mouth and anus are present at the opposite ends. Gill slits are numerous, paired and U-shaped. Examples include balanoglossus and secoglossus. Class 2, pterobranchia. In Greek, pteron means feather and branchion means gill. These are sedentary, solitary or colonial and tubiculous marine animals. Gill slits are one paired or may be absent. Alimentary canal is U-shaped. Sexes are separate or united. Single pair of gonads and gill slits are present. Examples are cephalodiscus and rhabdopleura. Class 3, Planctospheroidea. This class possess transparent, round and specialized chornaria larva. The representatives of this class possess L-shaped alimentary canal. Planctosphera pelagica is a representative of this class. Class 4, Graptolita. The fossil graptolites, example Dendrograptus, were abundant in Ordovian and Silurian periods. These are often considered as an extinct colonial class of hemichordata. Their tubular chitinous skeleton and colonial habits show an affinity with Rhabdopleura. Subphylum 2, Urochordata or Tunicata. In Greek, ora means a tail and corda means cord. These are exclusively marine and cosmopolitan, commonly known as sea squirts. An anterior branchial aperture and a dorsal atrial aperture are commonly present. Siloam is completely absent. A minute free-swimming tadpole larva possesses notochord and nerve cord only in tail region. Respiration occurs by gill slits and test. Adults are sac-like, covered with tunic, that is test. Sexes are united. Fertilization is external. Development is indirect, with tadpole larva having chordate characters. This subphylum has three classes. Class 1, Acidiaceae. The animals of this class are solitary, colonial or compound forms. They are all sessile sea squirts or acidians. Brachial sac is large and well developed. Larva is free swimming and highly developed and undergoes retrogressive metamorphosis. Most are fixed directly to the substratum, but a few have long stalks. Examples include Herdmania, Ciona and Molgula. Class 2, Thaliaceae. The representatives of this class are pelagic, free-swimming forms. Test is a permanent structure and the body is transparent, and in many, it is encircled by muscles which form or interrupt circular bands. The body is compressed, squirting out water for propelling the forward movement. Mouth and anterior lobes are at opposite end. Tail, nerve cord and notochord are absent in adults. Life history of this representative types exhibit alternation of generation. Examples are Salpa, Doliolum and Pyrosoma. Class 3, Larvaceae or Appendicularia. They are widespread, pelagic transparent animals of generally small size. The adults are retain many larval features including tail. Only two gill slits are present. An anus is open ventrally on the surface of the body. Examples are Oikopleura and Appendicularia. Subphylum 3, Cephalochordata. In Greek, cephal means head and chorda means cord. Cephalochordata is a small fish-like animal showing the main chordate characters. The notochord extends the entire length of the body, projecting beyond the nervous system to the tip of the snout. They have a dorsal tubular neural tube without a defined brain. Pharynx is large with numerous gill clefts. The gill clefts are equivalent to urochordates. There is a definite siloam. Examples include Branchiostoma and Asymmetron. Cephalochordata are closely related to urochordata. So, they cannot be assigned to two separate subphylum as is often done. They should be placed in the same phylum, Acrania. Group B, Craniata. These are aquatic or terrestrial. The Craniata includes a single subphylum, Vertebrata. Subphylum 4, Vertebrata. In Latin, vertebrate means backbone. The main character of this subphylum is notochord supplemented or replaced by a vertebral column or backbone comprising of a overlapping vertebra. Body is divisible into head, neck, trunk and tail. Vertebrates have a well-developed brain. The mouth cavity and the esophagus are connected by the pharyngeal gill slits to a muscular tube pharynx which opens to the exterior. They possess a dorsal hollow nerve tube at some stage of their life. digestive canal is more or less convoluted. They have a partially open circulatory system. Reproduction is normally sexual. These are dioecious. Development is direct or indirect. Vertebrata is the largest subphylum, including about 45,000 species. It is divided into two divisions, Ignata and Gnathostomata. Division 1, Ignata. In Greek, A means knot and Gnathos means jaw. These jawless fish-like vertebrates do not possess true jaws and paired limbs. The living Ignathans are cyclostomes. Ignata have a distinct head and skull, but cephalization is of a lower order. The skull is unique and difficult to homologize. They possess a permanent notochord. This division contains two classes. Class 1, Ostracodermi. In Greek, ostracon means shell and derma means skin. The animals of this class have bony dermal plates in the skin. These are small animals having a large, heavily armored head and a fish-like body and tail. They possess rounded gill slits. Examples are Cephalaspis and Pterapsis. Class 2, Cyclostomata. In Greek, cyclos means circular and stoma means mouth. Class Cyclostomata are the living Ignathans. Body is eel-like, long and cylindrical. The skin is soft and devoid of scales. Mouth is rounded or sectoral. Endoskeleton is cartilaginous. Cyclostomata includes lampreys and hagfishes. They have 5 to 16 pairs of internal gills in different species. Division 2, Gnathostomata. In Greek, gnathos means jaw and stoma means mouth. These are jawed vertebrates having true jaws and paired limbs. Gnathostomata consists of paired pectoral and pelvic appendages, paired nostrils, and a well-developed endoskeleton. It has been further divided into two superclasses, Pisces and Tetrapoda. Superclass 1, Pisces. In Latin, Pisces means fish. These are fishes or fish-like aquatic forms with paired as well as median fins, gills and scaly skin. There is always an exoskeleton of dermal scales. This superclass is further divided into three classes. Class 1, Plecodermi. Plecodermi are so called because they had heavy armor of body plates. They had paired fins and primitive jaws. A full-sized functional gill arc preceding hyoid arc is a characteristic of plecoderms. Examples are Clematius and Dinichthys. Class 2, Chondrichthys. In Greek, chondros means cartilage and ichthys means fish. These are mostly marine and carnivorous animals. Endoskeleton is made up of cartilage, so these are known as cartilaginous fishes. Skin contains minute plecoid scale. Gill slits are not covered with operculum. Mouth and two nostrils are present in ventral side. Males are with claspers. Examples include Scoliodon, Chimera, etc. Class 3, Ostichthys. In Greek, osteon means bone and ichthys means fish. These are freshwater and marine animals. Endoskeleton is bony type. Skin has various scale types such as cycloid and tenoid. Gill slits are covered with operculum. Males are without claspers. Examples are Labio, Protopterus, Hippocampus, etc. Superclass 2, Tetrapoda. In Greek, tetra means four and podos means foot. These land vertebrates contain two pairs of pentadictyle limbs and cornified skin. This superclass has been divided into four major classes. Class 1, Amphibia. In Greek, amphi means both and bios means life. Amphibians are aquatic freshwater or semi-aquatic animals. They can breathe in air and water and are carnivorous, cold-blooded and oviparous vertebrates. Adults are typically terrestrial and respire by lungs. Body is divisible into head and long trunk. Neck and tail may be present or absent. Limbs are tetrapodous, pentadactyl type, and digits are clawless. Some amphibians are limbless. Skin is smooth or rough and is rich in glands which keep the skin moist. Scales, if present, are hidden in the skin. Endoskeleton is mostly bony. Skull is with two occipital condyles. Vertebrae are centrous, pseudocentrous and notocentrous. Heart is divided into two atria and one ventricle. Respiration is through lungs, skin and buccal cavity lining. Gills are present during some early stages of development and also in some aquatic adults. Excretion is ureotelic. Brain is not well developed. Cranial nerves are in 10 pairs. Development is indirect. Some common examples are Rana, Bufo and Ambystoma. Class 2. Reptilia. In Greek, reptilis means covering. Reptiles are the first true land vertebrates. These are cold-blooded, terrestrial or aquatic air-breathing animals. Body is divisible into head, neck, trunk and tail, and is covered with horny scales. Limbs are pentadactyl type. Digits are with horny claws. However, limbs are absent in some lizards and snakes. Mouth is terminal and jaws are provided with simple conical teeth. Mandible consists of many pieces and articulates. Vertebrae are gastrocentrous. Lungs are used for respiration in terrestrial forms. Cloacal respiration takes place in certain turtles. Heart is three-chambered. Cerebellum of brain is well developed. Examples include Hemidactylus, Euromastix, Nadja, Sphenodon, Crocodilus, etc. Class 3. Aves. In Latin, avis means bird. Birds are feathered, winged, two-legged, warm-blooded, egg-laying vertebrates. There are nearly 10,000 known species of modern or recently extinct birds marked under class Aves. Hind limbs are modified for walking, perching or swimming. Heart is four-chambered and lungs are compact. Class 4. Mammalia. In Latin, mamma means breast. Mammals' bodies are usually covered with hair. A major characteristic of this class is females possess mammary gland which secretes milk for suckling the young. Heart is four-chambered. These are warm-blooded and air-breathing vertebrates. Approximately 4,500 well-known species belong to this class. The most common examples are Echidna, Macropus, Rattus and Homo sapiens. Let's summarize the talk. In this practical topic, we have discussed the general characteristics of phylum chordata with various examples. Chordates are animals possessing a notochord, a hollow dorsal nerve cord, pharyngeal slits, an endostyle, and a post-anal tail for at least some period of their life cycle. This phylum is divided into two groups such as Acrania or Protochordata and Craniata or Euchordata that show various contrasting characters. In the classification of the phylum, these groups are customarily arranged in larger functional divisions or subdivisions based on specific structures or features. Chordata is one of the largest phyla of deuterostomes. Hope this lecture was very fruitful in your understanding of general characters of chordates. Thank you.